I love playing in special places, and for me it's all about trying to capture the sound of like a place, the natural reverb of a place. And we sort of go to great lengths trying to find acoustic spaces, you know, and getting that sound of, you know, people playing in the room, you know, trying to incorporate natural sounds, acoustic sounds, upright bass, banjo, guitar, that kind of thing, violin. So, sound of like wood, you know.
There's a mark on my hand, put there by the land. There's a mark on my hand, put there by the land. There's a mark on my hand, put there by the land. There's a mark on my hand, put there by the land.
I wanted to have like, I really wanted to make the songs match what I heard in my head, you know, and sort of like really wanted to have a lot of control over how the songs were presented. And I think lately I've been more about trying to develop a kind of a chemistry with a band, and you know, becoming less of a solo project and more of a band project. You know? Well, I think I'm a little bit more prone to let the horses run wild. You know, and kind of like let things be a little bit untethered in the recording process. I'm kind of more drawn to that these days, I think, than trying to map everything out and arrange everything. I like kind of happy accidents, I guess.
Slow motion despite it all.
Process is really important to me. That is the reason why I get up in the morning, you know, is to kind of like feel that change in molecules in the air, you know, by when you sing or when you play an instrument, you sort of like change the sort of the feel of a place, change the feel of a room. You know, when someone sings, mm-hmm. or someone plays a guitar, it's such a, or an instrument of any sort, it's such a direct channel. It's such an easy way to feel the sort of the harmony of everything around you. You know? Maybe a sort of a heightened sense, a heightened sense of awareness. Or maybe it's a distraction, and it's enough of a distraction to, allow you to become at ease. You know?
I'm gonna switch gears a bit once we get the banjo tuned up. Somebody's got a banjo joke, is it? Okay, lay it on us. What is it? We've heard them all.
If I know equipment and I don't, how do we make it go?
the shapes that your body makes, that your body makes, that your body makes, that your body makes.
Thanks so much. This is such a great place to perform. It feels like, it kind of feels like I'm, you know, we're playing in somebody's living room or something. It's got that feel to it. It's a real treat to play here, so thanks again.
Moving pictures, silent. silent films, or is this the dream I've been saving?
Thank you so much.
I don't know, people have said that it's a sort of comforting music, you know, that kind of comes up again and again, that people, it's a kind of music where people can kind of find a solace, or people can find a comfort from, you know, hardship. I think that the music that we make is generally, I think, peaceful music, you know. And I think it's, for me, on a personal level too, I think I'm always trying to strive for that sort of sense of peace, you know, the sense of balance.
Still tune myself to the great key. I'm still mining for light in the dark wells. I'm still a frequency swaying leaf in the wind. I'm still searching for whispers in between yells.
I'm still.